Okay, children, now we are going to measure the angular velocity and the angular displacement of a clock. So, in my hand, I am having the clock. There is a, this one is a second hand and the minute hand is there. Now, let us take about the second hand. So this is moving, that is a rotational motion with respect to the center. Now let us make a point on this one. Let us take this as I am putting the point somewhere, number 4, and time is going on, it is rotating. Let us observe this motion up to this point 8. Okay, I have made a point from this point, you take it as A, and another point is B. Okay, so this is the observation that we have measured the values of this path, circular path, point A to point B. Now, in this one, how to calculate the angular velocity? Take a scale and make a line with respect to this center and the point B. Okay, now you have to, so this is the angle theta with respect to this diagram, and you are joining these two, A and B, with this circular manner. Already the circle is there in the clock, so that measurement we can take, or any it may be from the length of the second hand, that we can take it as the radius of the circle, and from center point to this one, that is the radius point O to A, center point, make it as O, and this is theta. So when it is a body, the second clock is rotating, and that moment will be called as a angular displacement. Let us take this angular displacement point A to B, that is a angle theta, and we know that angle is nothing but arc AB, and the radius, let us take this radius is R, radius of the circle. So the angle is equal to arc by radius, and the angular displacement also will be followed like this. So you have to take the measurement values on this, the radius of the circular path, that is here taking as this 8 centimeters coming. So the radius will be same throughout this circle. Now the distance between A to B, let us take this straight line, though it is a curved path, approximately we can take it as a straight line. That value might be, these are approximate, not everything is not perfect, but approximation we can say that it is near about 14 centimeter. So that we can say the radius is equal to 8 centimeter, and the length covered, that is angular displacement from point A to B, that arc length is 14 centimeter. Then we can do the calculation. The change in angular displacement is nothing but called angular velocity. So accordingly, substitute the values, the angle is equal to nothing but arc by radius, and come to this point here. This is in the calculation part, that you write this angular displacement will be theta to arc by radius. The value of this arc is taken as the 14 centimeter, and the radius is called 8 centimeter. So the angular displacement will be, you can find the value, and that will be calculated by simplifying that equation, you can will get this value for this angular displacement. And the angular velocity is equal to the change in the rate of change of angular displacement. That value you can put it here. That same thing will come. The time is taken as here. How much time is passed here from point 4 to here 8? That means you know that 4 to this one 5 centimeter plus to this 10, 15, 20 minutes. So you can substitute the values here. 14 by 8 into, let's divide by this. How much time you take? 20 seconds. Second hand you have taken. So second, 20 second. And find the value of this one, you will be getting the value of the angular velocity. So we could find out the value of this angular velocity. Let us take this value, 14 divided by 8 into 160 radians per second. And next, angular acceleration. You can simplify and get the answer. Next, angular acceleration. There is a rate of change of angular velocity only called as a angular acceleration. So here, let us say, consider this point A is a starting point, 0 point. So the change in velocity, that is initial angular velocity minus the final velocity minus initial angular velocity with respect to time. So rate of change of angular velocity is called angular acceleration. Let us say start this one, the angular for the point A is equal to 0. And it moved and it gone up to the point B. So that will be the point A. Here B will be the final and A will be the initial. So that we have to take. So from this one, the same angular velocity value can be taken. So this is in this case, then it will be 0 minus 14 point divided by 160 radians per second and divided by that time is 20. So do by yourself for what is the value of the calculation and tell me. So by this way we can calculate the angular velocity and angular acceleration with respect to the second law. If you are taking the minute hand also, then you can find it easily and you can understand how to calculate the angular velocity and angular acceleration with respect to this law. And also you can do another one. Calculation method is there by using the cycle. The wheel of the cycle when it rotates, when you are pedaling and the acceleration of the wheel will be getting. When the velocity of this cycle is increasing, then changing, then you can find the velocity of the rotation of